Hello everyone, this is Mar Haddad here. In this lecture, I'm going to show you how you can prevent your MikroTik router to have MNDP attacks. So what is the MNDP and what is the function of MNDP? And of course, we are going to see how the hackers will use the tool to be able to attack your router on MNDP. So MNDP is MikroTik Network Discovery Protocol. So that means that when you, for example, put your Winbox and you are connected your PC to the MikroTik router, on Winbox, you will directly see the entry of the MikroTik router to be able to connect to it. Okay, so I'm going to explain to you what is the network discovery protocols that MikroTik works on. And I'm going to show you later in a lab how you can do the attack. And of course, this attack is just to show you how you can prevent this type of attack. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do in this lecture. Let's first now go and see what is the network scenario. So here is our network scenario. I'm connecting my PC here to the MikroTik router on the interface Ethernet 2. So it's just a cable and I'm connected to it. And of course, we see here that there is an attacker using the Kali Linux. I'm gonna explain to you what is Kali Linux and why we need to use it, because we need to do the real attack to the MikroTik router, and then we are going to do the prevention to not have attack anymore on the router. So it's also a PC here connected to Ethernet 1, interface of the MikroTik router. So the idea is following. When we use MikroTik router, we have something we call the MikroTik Network Discovery Protocol, MNDP. So when you want to see the MikroTik router from your PC, for example, or from another device which is connected to the MikroTik router, there is some protocol that are being used here. And those protocols that MikroTik support are MNDP, he also support the CDP, which is Cisco Discovery Protocol, and LLDP. Those are the three protocols which works on layer 2 broadcast domain that the MikroTik router can use. So what is the idea here in the attack? Imagine that you have someone here on the who is connected to your MikroTik router, okay? And he's connected to Ethernet 1. By default, MNDP is enabled on all interfaces. And whether the interfaces have IPs or they don't have IPs, the MNDP and also the CDP and LLDP, they are enabled on all the interfaces of the MikroTik router. So in this case, if an attacker can reach to a connection to the MikroTik router via a cable, so he's on layer 2. What he can do, he can use something, a tool like Kali Linux, and he can use a tool inside the Kali Linux, and he can issue a lot of flooding of CDP, for example. So that means that the MikroTik router here, on its discovery, the neighbor discovery, he will have one neighbor, two neighbors, three neighbor, four neighbor, and so forth. He will have multiple entries of neighbors, while in this case, he doesn't have any neighbors. You only have two PCs when you see here on the network. So what the attacker can do, he will fool the MikroTik router and he will send a lot of entries inside the MikroTik router. So the MikroTik router see himself connected to many different devices, while in fact it is not. And what this has an effect on the MikroTik router, when they do this attack, you have many thousands of entries as neighbors on the MikroTik router. This would cause that your CPU will go very high, and of course your memory will be full because it is incrementing the entries inside the MikroTik router. And this affects the router to not function anymore as it should be. Okay, so this is a tool that the hackers or the attackers use in order to make your network not working anymore well, because everything has to pass, in this case, to the MikroTik router. And if the MikroTik router have a lot of flood from the flooding of the CDP neighbors that the attacker is doing, then he will not have any more resources to do the other tasks like routing or wireless or switching or anything else. Okay, so now this is the whole idea of what is the MNDP attack. As you already know it, let's go back now and start with the pawns, and I will show you a brief example using the Kali Linux, and we are using a tool inside Kali Linux to be able to do the attack, and then how we can prevent that. Point number one, go to Kali Linux and from the command prompt write wine-winbox.exe and connect to the MikroTik router. So let's put the picture here and let's do that. We have first to go to the Kali Linux, and that's the one. Of course, I'm not gonna explain to you how you can install Kali Linux and how it works, because that's a course by itself. If you want, you can register to any other courses for other instructors which are teaching Kali Linux. But just to mention that Kali Linux is an operating system, it's a Linux based, from where you can connect to the MikroTik router, for example, and you can do attacks for testing, and then you can see how you can prevent those attacks to happen. So first, let me connect. Here they said we have to go to the terminal. So I open the terminal, and here I have to write wine winbox.exe. That's only to open the winbox and to connect to the MikroTik router. So this is the winbox open here, and you can see this is my MikroTik router, and I connect to it. Let me move it a little bit down here so you can see. So yeah, I will connect to it, and here we go. I'm now connected to the MikroTik router. Port number one is done. Port number two, we need to open a new command line from Kali Linux and write Yersinia minus G. So on the Kali Linux, I'm gonna now use a software or a tool which is called Yersinia. From this tool, I'm able to make the attack to the MikroTik router, the MNDP attack. All right, so let's go back to Kali Linux. And from here, I will open a new window. And they said here that I have to write Yersinia minus capital G, which is the graphical. And here we go. So this is the tool that I need to use in order now to make the CDP attacks, or the MNDP, of course, because CDP and MNDP and LLDP, they are all used on the MikroTik router to have network discovery device. Okay, so this is the application that I need to open now, and then I have to start in the upcoming point, start doing the attack. Port number two is done. Port number three, click on launch attack and select flooding CDP table. So from the Yersinia software, I have to go and launch the attack and select flooding CDP table. So let's do that. We go here again to Kali Linux, and here I have to say launch attack. And before I do that, we need to do here is to go to, we close on Winbox everything, and I have to go to IP and then neighbors. You can see that this is what is showing now on the neighbors. So again, when we click on launch attack, we have this appearing. Then I will click on flooding CDP table, and I will say okay. And look here on the IP neighbor, what's going to happen. You can see now the MikroTik router is now getting attacks, and he's seeing up to now 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 neighbors for him. And you can see this is the entries. Those are the entries. It's full now. And if we keep this, it's now already 9,000 entries, and it's going increment. And you see the attack is not stopping. And if you want, we have to go also, we can go to system resources. And from the resources here, we can look to the CPU. You can see the CPU load is now 63%, 72%. So you can see because the attack is keep going, and this will cause that the CPU will be increasing. And of course, if we look to the memories, we will see also that the memories are getting full. Okay, you can see that the attack is non-stopping, and all those are entries, and we are already on 30,000 entry, and those are the router would think that those are neighbors for him. So point number three is done. Point number four, look to the IP neighbor on the MikroTik router and see how many neighbors are being learned. Check the CPU also. So we already have seen that. So this point also is done. Now stop the attack from Yersinia. Let's go back to Kali Linux. You see the attack is still ongoing. We are 42,000, 43,000. So let's stop the attack. Here we have to click on list attacks. And here the running attacks, I will say, okay, I want to stop it. We can also say stop all. Okay, so the attack has been stopped now. And directly you will see that the router in a moment will be more healthy. Point number five is done. Point number six, now we need to start doing the prevention to not have such a problem anymore. So we have to find a way where, in case an attacker is connected to my router, and he's doing this type of attack, my router is not being affected. So how to do that? Before I doing it, let me just explain it to you briefly on the graph what we are going to do. So we said at the beginning that discovery is always enabled on all interfaces. So what I need to do here is to say, okay, Ethernet 2 is the interface that I trust because I'm connected to it. So I will leave the discovery on that interface. And Ethernet 1 or any other interfaces, I don't want to have the discovery on them because they are not connected to my computer directly. So in this case, what we need to do, we have to make the configuration where we can list that the network discovery has to be enabled on Ethernet 2, but on the other interfaces has to be disabled. Then in this case, if this attacker is trying to make an attack here, it's not gonna work because if the attack is launching, but this interface say, okay, I don't have here the network discovery protocol enabled on this interface, then I will not add any neighbor to this interface, okay, on my router. So in this case, you save yourself and you say, I only want that the network discovery protocol to be enabled on the interface Ethernet 2. So this is the whole idea how you can protect yourself from such type of attacks. Let's go back now and start doing the points. Point number 6, go to interface, then interface list, and create a new interface list and name it neighbor. All right, so what we can do, if you want, I can connect. Let me just connect to Winbox from here and not from Kali Linux. So of course we can also keep working on Kali Linux, but from Windows, from here it's more clear and it's bigger. So we go back to the router. So they're saying here that all you need to do is you have to, let me close all those, you have to go to interfaces. So this is interfaces, and then from interface list over here you have to create on list, and then here you will create a list and you can give it the name you want. Let's give it name of neighbor, and then I will click OK, and you can see it's shown over here. Point number 6 is done. Point number 7, put interface Ethernet 2 as a member of the interface list neighbor. So we go here, and now what I need to do is to, after I create the interface list which is having name of neighbor, I will click on plus here, and I will say the list which is neighbor has inside of it Ethernet 2, because I want to discover on the interface Ethernet 2, I want to discover the neighbors, okay? So I will say here, okay. And you can see it is over there. Point number 7 is done. Point number 8, go to IP neighbor and set discovery settings to previous interface list being made, which is the neighbor. So I have to go now, after I put Ethernet 2 over here, I have to say that the interface list, which is neighbor, which having Ethernet 2, is the one which have the discovery neighbor protocol enabled on it. So I'll have to go to IP, I have to go to neighbors, and discovery settings over here. You can see the discovery settings by default is all. So that means it's enabled on all interfaces. Now what I need to do, I have to say, I want it to be enabled on neighbor, and inside neighbor there is Ethernet 2. That means that the discovery is only enabled on neighbor, on Ethernet 2. And then I will say, okay. Point number 8 is done. Point number 9, relaunch the MNDP attack. Does it affect the router with the neighbor entries? So let's check again. We have to go to Yersinia, and I will say launch attack and flood CDP table like I've done before. And then I will say, okay. And we can see that the attack is running. Let's go to the router now and see what's happening. So this is the router. I will move it big again. And you can see the neighbor list, there is no any entry. Why? Because if you look again to the picture, if you go back to the picture, the attack is happening on Ethernet 1. Let's clean it a little bit, and we can see that the attack is happening on Ethernet 1. While we said that the discovery is enabled only on Ethernet 2, but on Ethernet 1 is not. That means it will not add those entries that are coming from the Kali Linux, from Yersinia software. And if you want, what we can do, because the attack is running now, what I can do, I can go back here and I can say discovery and let me put all again. And then I will say, okay, look what's going to happen. You see, directly it's showing up the attacks, okay? And if I put discovery now, neighbor, so the only to be on the internet too, and then directly those are gone, which means that my configuration that I have done, it's working perfectly, and this is helping the router to not have problems of MNDP attacks or the CTP floods attacks that I just explained to you in this lab. Point number 9 is done, and with this point I have just explained to you one type of attack, which is MNDP attack, and the prevention of it, so how you can prevent it. Of course, again, it is very important that you can make prevention for all types of attacks when an attacker is trying to do on your router. And one of the things is the MNDP attack. So I just showed you with the Kali Linux using Yersinia how you can do the attack, and then I showed you how you can prevent it, and we have seen that everything works perfectly without any problem. So I hope that you enjoyed this lecture, and I will see you in the upcoming lecture.